That lady is Miss Cecily Cardew, my ward.
I'm engaged to be married to Cecily, Aunt Augusta.
Oh, beg your pardon.
Miss Moncrief and I are engaged to be married, Lady Bracknell.
I do not know whether there is anything peculiarly exciting in the air of this particular part of Hertfordshire, but the number of engagements that go on seem to be well above the proper average. Mr. Worthing, might I inquire if Miss Cardew is remotely connected to any of the larger railway stations in London? I hear I desire information. Until yesterday, I was not aware that there were any families or persons whose origin was a terminus.
Miss Cardew is the granddaughter of the late Mr. Thomas Cardew of 149 Belgrave Square, SW. Gervais Park, Dorking, Surrey, and the Sporran, Fifeshire, NB.
But that seems not unsatisfactory. Three addresses always inspire confidence, even in tradesmen quiet. But what proof about their authenticity?
I have carefully preserved the court guides of the period. They are open during inspection, Lady Bracknell.
I have known strange errors in that publication.
Miss Cardew's family solicitors are Messrs. Markby, Markby and Markby.
Markby and Markby. A firm of the very highest position in their profession. Indeed, I am told that one of the Mr. Markbys can occasionally be seen at dinner parties. So far, I am satisfied.
How extremely kind of you, Lady Blackwell. I have also in my possession, you'll be pleased to hear, certificates of Miss Cardew's birth, baptism, whooping cough, registration, vaccination, confirmation, and the measles, both the German and the English variety.
A life crowded with incident, I suppose. Though perhaps somewhat too exciting for a young girl, I am not myself in favour of premature experiences.
Gwendolyn?
The time approaches for our departure. We have not a moment to lose. As a matter of form, Mr. Worthing, I had better ask you if Miss Cardew has any little fortune.
No.
About £130,000 in the funds, that is all. Goodbye, Lady Bracknell. So pleased to have seen you.
A moment, Mr. Worthing. £130,000. And in the funds. Miss Cardew seems to be... The best detective young. Lost and improved with time. We live, I regret to say, in an age of surfaces. However, sweet child, your dress is sadly simple. Your hair, almost as nature might have left it, but we can soon alter all that. A thoroughly experienced French maid produces a wonderful result in a very brief space of time. I remember recommending one to young Lady Lancy, and after 3 months, her own husband did not know her.
And after 6 months, nobody knew her.
Turn round, sweet child. No, no. Side view is what I want.
Yes, just as I expected.
There are distinct social possibilities in your profile. The two weak points in our age are its want of principle, want of profile. Chin a little higher, dear. Style largely depends on the way the chin is worn. They're worn very high. Algernon.
Yes, Aunt Augusta.
There are distinct social possibilities in Miss Carter's profile.
Cecily is the dearest, sweetest, prettiest girl in the whole world, and I don't care tuppence about social possibilities.
Never speak disrespectfully of society, Algernon. Only people who can't get into it do that. Dear child, of course, you realize Algernon has only his debts upon which to depend. But I am not in favour of mercenary marriages. When I married Lord Bracknell, I had no fortune of any kind. But I never dreamed for a moment of allowing that to stand in my way. Well, I suppose I had better give my consent.
Thank you, Aunt Augusta.
Cecily, you may kiss me.
Thank you, Lady Bracknell.
You may also address me as Aunt Augusta Eugenie for the future.
Thank you, Aunt Augusta Eugenie.
The marriage, I think, had better take place quite soon.
Thank you, Aunt Augusta Eugenie.
Thank you, Aunt Augusta Eugenie.
I beg your pardon for interrupting you, Lady Bracknell, but this engagement is quite out of the question. I am Miss Cardew's guardian, and she cannot marry without my consent until she comes of age. That consent I absolutely decline to give.
On what grounds, may I ask? Algernon is an extremely, I may say, almost ostentatiously eligible young man. He has nothing, but he looks everything. What more can one desire?
It pains me very much to have to speak frankly to you, Lady Bracknell, about your nephew, but the fact is that I do not approve at all of his moral character. I suspect him of being untruthful.
Untruthful? My nephew